to me, I think there are really special things about this project. One of them had to do with the community involvement, to see people of all ages really sort of getting into this. It was really a great opportunity for us as designers to understand what the community was looking for.
It definitely had a huge impact on both the design and I think us as designers. We really like when people want to get involved in the design process, and this park design is a product of that. We think that the result here and what's in the ground today really reflects the desires of the community.
We went ahead and partnered with some community groups to host some community design events, and we invited the residents of this community to come in and give us some thoughts about their hopes and dreams and sort of visions for this park. The fact that we engage the community in the actual design of it. So I think that process is probably the greatest thing. The Trust for Public Land is a national nonprofit that works to protect land and build parks and playgrounds. We have an office here in New Jersey, in Newark. So everybody that works in the Newark office is all focused on New Jersey all the time. Our organizational mission is that everybody in the country should live within a 10-minute walk of a park or a playground.
Passaic County went into a cooperative agreement with the Trust for Public Land, the New Jersey Department of Environmental Protection, the City of Passaic, and the Passaic County Open Space Funding.
Hearing about the desire for it to be a more family-oriented park. I think the way we've designed it to integrate not just a play area but benches so that parents can sit together and talk while the kids are playing. We added a level of safety with the fences around the play area to really make it more family-friendly.
Studies show that people's health indicators and their enjoyment of their life, their enjoyment of their neighborhood really is tied to access to open spaces. The closer that you could have those facilities and resources, the better. There's about 8,000 people that live within a 10-minute walk of this park. So those folks are going to get to enjoy that right away in a very easy access.
We also have a fitness area that's just to the north of the soccer field. And then right now, what is the current north end of the park, there is an amphitheater. In addition to these human wants for the project, we were able to do it and still bring back some level of nature to the park also. There are other program items such as a community garden where people can grow vegetables. We've got rain gardens that are right next to the river.
And all of our plantings were chosen to be mostly native to the site. There are rain gardens and native wet meadows woven throughout the park. We have planted about almost 700 trees and then 50,000 plantings. And it's nice because the Riverwalk becomes this tactile experience for people of all ages. We wanted to make sure that everything we chose for the playground had this riverine, natural planting theme. You can see in the pattern of the safety surface, it's kind of a winding, sinuous river pattern.
Sort of blending of park uses to accommodate people, but also to accommodate nature, revealing nature to people who are coming to the park.
The building looks kind of different when you first come in because it sits up so high because of the floodplain that's here. So the water may rise and we had to keep the building up out of that. So instead of thinking that as like a challenge, we took it as an opportunity to kind of create a large set of steps out in front that kind of act as an amphitheater or a gathering place. Because we're in the floodplain, we could only cover so much of the park with a paved surface, with, you know, like an asphalt or a regular concrete. So what we did was we worked with the engineer to come up with a pervious concrete. So the water that lands on the concrete sidewalks in this park will go right through it, as opposed to washing off and going into a drain system. This, it kind of perks right through and goes down into the ground.
Dundee Island Park is the first park that Passaic County has built in 50 years.
Passaic County in general has the amenity of the Passaic River going through it, as well as some other rivers. So I think that this park, for the Passaic County park system as a whole, I think this is a good example of how we can kind of have value for all different members of the community, for the county as a whole, as well as the city of Passaic.